Hi, welcome back to carving a German short-haired pointer. I'm sure you can hear the rain falling outside. It's an easterly wind, it's pretty cold. We've got the heater on, I've got my thermal boots on and my flight cap, well it's not my flight cap, my baseball cap. So we've just had a quick look at these pictures that we've got in here to see where we're going next with this pointer. And basically I think the nose is too big, so we've just measured up again, and it's 20mm across the nose, so we need to take some more material off the width of that nose, reduce that, work on the eye sockets, see if we can get those looking a bit more realistic, then we might have a go at these ears. So that's the next thing. I'll just put my mask on and we'll start work. I'll try and keep you up to date with what we're doing, give you descriptions. Right, there we go. So we'll start now. So the first thing, we've measured this nose up and we think it's far too big. And by reducing this nose, as you can see the picture, it now gives us this drop between, let's call them the lips, and the bottom of the nose. It gives us more of a distance, which we didn't have before, so that's quite good. So all I'm doing at the moment is just drawing basic guidelines out to give myself an idea of where we're going. So we've measured off the actual picture we used for the profile, which is this one. We've measured that nose, transfer that onto there. We're going to reduce the width of this nose, and we've looked at this picture here. There's an angle there which is, I don't know what you call it, part of the nose, so we're going to use that and hopefully everything will be all right. This, so I'm going to be very careful with how I use it. I'm just tickling the wood with this at the moment. Thank you. Same on the other side.
Thank you.
We're not doing the vents in the nose yet. We're just trying to get the nose near enough. These pointers have a very definite, very peculiar note. Well, I'm not saying peculiar, but I say a nose peculiar to them. Obviously, I don't know if you can see it. Sticks out quite a bit. Big nostrils. So, trying to get that near enough. We're going to do the vents next and see what that looks like. We're at 17 minutes at the moment, so we'll do a bit more. We'll take you around to about the 20 minute mark, so you're not getting bored. And now we'll start a new bit. So, little carbon tungsten. Bit, and then where the you can see it's serrated. We're going to use that on the nostrils and just try and get them in. Okay, so that's the first bit. Let's see what we're going to use next on this. could try and use another carbon tungsten bit. Let me see. Looks like down here. Maybe you see the. There you go. You can see it's serrated. Pretty old, pretty worn out. Whether it'll do anything, I'm not sure. I think actually it's too wide for what I want. I'm going to look for something different. I'm going to try a diamond impregnated burr. That's all working out. There you go. See what that does. What you've got on the nose here is a very definite continuation of this, I don't know what you'd call it really, let's call it a vent. It comes round the front and goes up down the outside. So we'll try and incorporate that. I don't know if you can see too well. Well, we'll do the other side now and tickle it up. we're still cleaning this nose area up, just working on it, opening up the nostrils, making them quite deep. The deeper they look, or the deeper they are, the better they look, I think. And then you can make them dark when you come to colour, and hopefully they'll look relatively realistic. Right, we're on to 32 minutes. I'm going to stop you here.